Good morning, my name is Lisa and I'm currently travelling around Japan for 2 weeks with my boyfriend Matt. We have just been to Hakone, then Osaka, and then today we are going over to Kyoto, and thankfully it is not a long journey away because there is so much to see in Kyoto. The weather is looking perfect today, so we're going to go and see as much as possible, probably renting bikes. It's going to be really good fun, so come along and see what we get up to in our 2 nights in Kyoto. There's going to be kimono wearing, there's going to be temple seeing, it's all going to be happening, so I hope you enjoy the video. And if you are interested in more Japan content, I have already posted videos on Hakone and Osaka, and after Kyoto we are heading into the Japanese Alps to hire a car and then finishing off in Tokyo with some Disney as well. So come along for the ride, I hope you enjoy. Before we check out, here's a quick look at our tiny little room. This is what constitutes as the wardrobe. The main room here, decent sized bed, window out to nothing, little table and chair. As you can imagine, it was difficult to get two suitcases in this amount of space. And then a bathroom, toilet, shower. This is weird. The sink turns on via the shower controls. But yeah, it did us really well. Would recommend. Super cheap, super good location, and you can upgrade to a bigger room as well. This was a slightly chaotic travel experience with all of our suitcases. We also tried to get Ekibens on the Shinkansen with us. We did succeed, but that then meant we had 15 minutes to scoff the whole thing and then get off again. It was a lot. So we dropped the bags off at the hotel and went straight to hire these cute little bikes. You might notice that they are way too small for both of us. This is the tallest, you know, highest seat setting that the bikes had. Built for small people, so my legs were aching in ways that they had never ached before from this trip. But oh my gosh, it was so peaceful, the weather was perfect, I was absolutely loving exploring by bike. This can be my vlog day if you want.
My vlog day.
You did say you wanted to do videoing one day, didn't you? This did indeed turn into Matt vlog day because I cannot be trusted with cycling and using a camera at the same time. So here are some of the things that Matt decided were worth videoing. I'm really glad that he did film because otherwise it was just me following the directions on my phone all day. We have cycled through the Imperial Palace grounds. I have to say there's not a huge amount to see. But if you're a fan of gravel, I have to say, this is the most gravel I've ever seen in my entire life. We're basically like swimming through it on these bikes. So I think we'll be glad to exit over there. At least we've ticked it off. We've cycled across half of Kyoto on our good little bikes here. And that was really, really fun. The weather literally could not be more perfect today. It is delightful. And we've come to the Golden Temple, Golden something. Big egg and a baby egg. How many you have to?
Was this eating it first?
Nom nom nom. We had refueled with beautiful ramen and ice cream. Everyone else in Kyoto was also at the Golden Pavillion. There were tour groups from cruise lines, there were school groups. It was the place to be, which wasn't the most relaxing experience, but you know, you've got limited time, you've got to go see these places while you can. And it was beautiful to look at, but I feel like it would have just been so much more beautiful if it was nice and peaceful and quiet. But I was still really glad that we went because the colours on the pavilion are just beautiful, and it was such a cool little place to explore. Definitely worth the visit. Renowned as an
one
coin,
okay.
Oh, that wasn't bad.
Not too bad.
You have a go. Yeah. Oh, did you get it? Yeah. Oh my god. Of course you bloody did.
First try.
The leaves are just turning. I'm quite jealous of someone who comes in here in like 2 weeks. I have to say I am absolutely loving the bikes, particularly e-bikes. It's just so easy, it's so chill. Kyoto seems like the perfect place typical cycling, particularly compared to some of the other places we've been to in Japan. And now we just come 10 minutes up the road to this other beautiful temple that is one of Matt's favourites. Having the bikes with us just meant that we had so much more freedom to try out these spots that are away from the main tourist trail. And yeah, if you compare the amount of crowds here to the last place, it was a little bit insane. I think I might have preferred this one. We just sat in a 1,000-year-old cafe, I guess, where they've been making mochi for 1,000 years, and had some little tea and mochis covered in some sort of sauce, and you could see them making them outside, which was pretty cool. We've been doing such varied things on this trip, like no 2 hours are the same, let alone no 2 days. It's really nice. This is where we are right now. It's quite cool because you can just walk along, see all these different temples and shrines and stuff, and it's ridiculously quiet. I mean, it is now, everything closes in a few minutes, so obviously it's quieter than normal, but I really like this hotel. You have to take your shoes off here, go put them in a locker, and then everyone goes barefoot in the whole hotel, which is quite fun. We made it to the Kyoto Hotel after some rush hour traffic situation, but it was all fine. I really enjoyed hiring the bikes. That was definitely a good decision. So we've got this, well, first of all, it's a hotel where you leave your shoes in a little locker at reception, and then you walk around in your socks, which is fun. Toilet slippers, which you wear in the toilet only. Obviously all of the Japanese functionality. There's even a seat in the shower because we're going to be tired from all the Kyoto walking. And then in the main room there's this little bench, big bed that is way bigger than the last bed. That'll be nice. Very soundproof, massive TV, loads of room compared to the last place. So this will do us nicely for 2 nights. Oops. We've done a classic Lisa and Matt thing and overordered, and don't ask me why. I thought that they would be like roast potatoes, Japanese stuff, and they're just wedges. But yeah, there's a lot going on. Good morning from Kyoto. Here's a view from our room. All the Tory gates. There is where we are, and then it goes all the way up there. That's a lot of gates. Let's go. We decided to head to this shrine super early in the morning, well, early for us, because we know how iconic it is and everyone who comes to Kyoto gets their photo taken here, which is a blessing and a curse because it did feel a little bit like an Instagram photo mill at times where everyone was just running away to try and get the perfect picture with no one else in it, which was very difficult to achieve even early in the morning. Always takes a little bit of the shine off it, but we still had a lovely time walking up to see the beautiful view at the top, which made it all worth it. So we made it to the halfway point to the viewing platform and then decided that it wasn't worth going all the way to the summit. I have to say, the sweat is getting on already and it's only 9 a.m. So we're heading back down now. I love how we're in a shrine, but there are cocktails available if you are so inclined. What's going on in here? I feel like Tory gates have now lost all their meaning because I've seen about 10,000 this morning. We left our little bikes in the bike park and we have to pay 200 yen to get them out when we're done. And we're still 400 metres down the hill from where we're going, so let's go see what's going on. Oh my gosh, we have found the tour groups once again on our way up to Kiyomizu-dera temple. It was intense, but honestly this was my favorite temple potentially of the whole trip. I really loved it. I just loved how it revealed itself to us bit by bit. First you were walking through the old style town, and then you saw one part of the temple, and then another part, and then this absolutely iconic viewing platform. I was in love. So pretty. We are sadly a week or two ahead of the leaves once again, but still stunning. Hello vlog. I'm bloody knackered. It's only 10 to 11 and my legs are on fire, and we've just walked all the way down the hill, and if this is not the exit and I have to walk all the way back up, I might cry. Kyoto is no joke. I hate fish, but I do appreciate they are a Japanese icon. Oh my god. That is insane sugar levels. Wow, it's really tasty.
Going to do a mukbang this. Dumplings are on.
And then we released our bikes from their 200 yen prison in the bike parking area and cycled back through Kyoto for our last little bit of our 24-hour bike rental, which I think I might have mentioned already. I really enjoyed, and I highly recommend it if you're into cycling at all. It was super easy, loads of quiet roads like this, and it did help that the temperature was perfect as well. So yeah, that was most of our temple viewing down, and then we headed over to the Gion neighborhood for a little surprise. Do you like my new outfit? I think I'm gonna have to switch into my sandals. This is not gonna be very... I want some street food.
So how do you feel about the kimono, Lisa?
Well, Matt, it was quite the experience. It was quite fun, actually. Like, there's a lot of decision making, which I would say I'm not very good at. So you have to pick out which color you want, which this, if you want this. Even like this under bit, they're like, oh, do you want to upgrade it to a fancier one? And it's like, who's going to even see that? But yeah, it was good fun, and they did my hair, which was nice. I never have my hair done. It was really cool to see the lady like folding this fabric to make it into this, and there's about like so many folds under this bit. I've put on about 2 inches, to be fair, with all this fabric.
Do a spin.
The umbrella fell down. I feel like Bridget Jones when she's doing that the sit up Britain with Daniel Cleaver in the second film. Oh yes, what can I say?
It's trying to rain.
The thunder is coming, so maybe I won't be in it for very long. Before I came on this trip, I really wanted to do this, and I researched it, and everyone was like, no, it's definitely cultural appreciation, not cultural appropriation. Like, Japanese people love it that foreign tourists dress up. And then I got here and I was like, oh my god, I don't want to do it. But now I'm glad that I did.
You're not the only one here that has on as well.
There's a crew of us. So because I'm tall, I only had about 10, 15 options to choose from. I feel like all the short people get the better colour options, but what can you do? We went to such a cool izakaya for dinner, where you pick everything on an iPad and every single item is 360 yen, which is under £2. So a cocktail under £2, the best edamame I've ever had in my life under £2, chicken sticks less than £2. So needless to say, we ordered a lot of food and had a really fun time. So we ordered an absolute ton of stuff, 2 drinks each, pudding to share, and it comes to 4,680 yen, which is about, well, it's under £30 for two of us, which is pretty good.
Including a whiskey.
Yeah. Well, four drinks, yeah. And here is our chocolatey waffle or pudding. And just like that, we are all packed up and ready to leave Kyoto. We had a really cute night last night. Place we went for dinner, I highly, highly recommend. I'll leave all information about places that we've been and stayed in the description, so have a look there if you want to see. And now we are all packed up. The suitcases are ready for our next adventure into the Japanese Alps, which should hopefully be a bit of chill after four full days of like running around like maniacs going to Osaka and Kyoto. Did we see absolutely everything in Kyoto? No. But did we have a great time and not go too mad? Yes. I did really want to walk around Gion at night last night, but we did go through, oh, what's it called? Pontocho, something like that. And I'm pretty sure that we saw a real geisha saying goodbye to her guests. She was like an older, like more senior geisha, so she didn't have like the white Mako powder on, but she had the proper kimono, she had the hair, so that was really cool. That was a good way to end the trip. So yeah, thank you for watching this one. Hope you come along with us to the Japanese Alps, where we're staying in Shibu Onsen. So I hope to see you there. Thanks for watching. Bye.